We're on the way to the infamous Chevy Chase skate park here in LA, and we're about to go intro the first official rider for Progress Daily.
What's up?
Wait, you want me to roll back?
Yeah, can you do that one more time, please? Whoa, dude, what's up?
What is good, bro?
Dude, you're so tall in person. I had no idea.
This one's harder.
That's the one you do a lot, huh?
Yeah, that's the one I always do.
I first noticed Brian from a YouTube video titled How to Spot a Poser at a Skate Park. I think the funniest part was how serious he was.
But there's a difference between beginners and posers, so that's what I'm gonna be talking about today.
But then I saw some clips of him skating Brails Park. Not only is he someone who's driven to build a platform for himself, but he's even more driven to just be a better skateboarder.
What?
The fucking ugliest I could have done it.
Oh, wait.
Oh, fuck.
Wait.
God damn, shut up, Dale.
What about a fakie varial flip?
Damn.
All right, now what? You call it.
Double backside flip?
Alright.
Double backside flip?
Yeah.
Really?
I'll skate with Brian. We'll do some, maybe try some tricks.
I'm sorry, two people are talking to you. What did you say?
You want to film a couple tries? And then we'll just watch it?
Yeah. John said make sure you hit record. I'm really sick. John's gonna have to put hand sanitizer on his camera after this. Good to see you guys though. I haven't seen you guys in a while. Yeah, I'm not sure if he has like a completely different audience or not.
I'm the new John.
Yeah, it's the new
I'm the
John.
Better John.
Thank you, G. Come on, appreciate it.
What, dude? Nah?
Bitch.
What got you into all the late tricks?
The first late trick at all that I learned was just the ollie late front shove, which is now my favorite trick.
Yeah.
Honestly, I learned it from a Tony Hawk trick tip. So at like 8 years old, I was trying them in my...
You've been skating since you were how old?
7.
How long have you been filming with Braille? And did you watch them growing up?
Yeah, okay, so Braille was probably like the first YouTube channel that I started watching, like in general. The channel name was Sprocker7 back then. It wasn't even Braille yet, like Braille wasn't a thing.
Yeah.
And I was just watching all these trick tips. He taught me how to nose slide, crooked grind. And then I got into like Andy's videos, started watching like Sam Tabor when he got on the team and all that. So like all the dudes, Casey Beckler, Basquith.
Wow. So you grow up on the YouTube.
Yeah, for sure.
That's crazy.
Wouldn't even really watch skate videos.
Right. Did you want to be popular on social media when you were young?
Yeah, I would try to start like just mainstream YouTube channels. Like I would try to film like Day of My Life type thing when I was like 10 years old on like my iPod Touch, you know, just like sitting in my room talking about like updates and stuff as if anyone was watching me, you know, I'd get like 11 views like
That's
on
amazing.
My channel, but I was still like acting like I had an audience. I always knew like I wanted to do that, like social media.
How are people in school with that kind of stuff?
You know, it starts off like making jokes, you know, people like, oh, the YouTuber kid, or like, oh, you're famous, like,
yeah.
Like making fun of it, like teasing. A bunch of like my friends were saying like, yeah, I want to do it like after high school, so nobody from like high school, you know, like caps
gotcha.
On me and stuff, you know, but like, I mean, like, it's better to start as soon as you want to, you know?
Do you think it's important nowadays for skateboarders who are coming up to try to get into posting on social media and growing their accounts?
Yeah, because I mean, that's gonna bring, you know, business to the company, and I've seen pro skaters who, some don't even have Instagrams, to be honest, and like they kill it, but not every company is gonna want that, you know?
Yeah, I mean, that's very rare, I feel like, nowadays, to be like a popular pro who doesn't post.
Yeah.
What are some of your goals in skateboarding? Like, what are you trying to achieve, like, with skateboarding in general?
Every late trick possible. My goals are always changing in skateboarding. When I was like 14, I was set on trying to be a pro skater. And then when I realized I couldn't skate handrails, I knew that wasn't gonna happen. Then like a couple years later, I was just trying to learn as many new tricks as I could. And then I started working on like my style a little more around like 17, 18. And now I'm just doing it for fun. Well, it's always been for fun, but like now I don't really like focus on too much on one thing.
Welcome to the team, dude. I appreciate it. You're actually the first dude I'm announcing to the team, by the
way.
Yeah.
Why are we holding hands for something?
I don't know.
Skateboarding, you know there is no one else who can skate like Brian. I've never seen anyone as consistent at such hard tricks and who does them with such style. There are 10 riders that I'm looking at right now, 3 from California, 3 from Texas, 2 international, and 2 local to me in New York City, and I'm gonna be announcing them hopefully in just the weeks to come. But in California, I'm filming 3 of my favorite skateboarders ever, and this is Brian, the official first dude on the team.
So that other door doesn't open?
No, well, like it'll open, but it wouldn't close.
Sorry, I stepped in your seat.
But it opens up from the inside, though.
No.
Ugh. Oh, that's the best way to do it.
Blown.
Wow. It's like that.
My nipples burn.
Each skateboarder that I add to the team has their specific element that they can add. Brian is the best at doing what he does, and the other people that I'll be adding are the best at what they do. There's a car creeping behind me, huh? Anyways, feel free to subscribe, and I'll see you guys next week. Every Wednesday right now, I'm uploading a new video. I'm so pumped.